looking into how autophagy and intermittent fasting work together, revealing the cell cleansing process for health. In the past few years, the coming together of science and nutrition has shed new light on the interesting relationship between what we eat and how our cells work. Among these, autophagy, the process by which cells clean themselves and make new cells, has become a key player in keeping cells healthy and long-lasting. At the same time, intermittent fasting, IF, a diet plan that switches between eating and not eating, has become more common because it might be good for your health. Autophagy and intermittent fasting work together to help each other. This piece looks at how intermittent fasting can boost autophagy and uses real-life examples to show how they can improve health and well-being. Understanding autophagy. The word autophagy comes from the Greek words auto, meaning self, and phagein, meaning to eat. It is a tightly controlled cellular process that breaks down and recycles broken or non-working cell parts. When autophagosomes form, they take in damaged proteins, worn-out organelles, and viruses that are trying to infect cells. They then send this stuff to lysosomes to be broken down. This process of recycling not only keeps cells working, but it's also a key part of how cells deal with stress and how they avoid getting diseases like cancer and neurodegenerative illnesses. Intermittent fasting, a trip to renewing cells. There are a few famous ways to do intermittent fasting, including the 16-8 method, 16 hours of fasting and 8 hours of eating, alternate day fasting and the 5-2 diet, eating normally for 5 days, and limiting calories for 2 days that are not consecutive. Intermittent fasting has been done for hundreds of years for religious, cultural, and health reasons. It has recently become more popular again because of studies showing that it might be good for your health. It's possible that autophagy and intermittent fasting are linked. One interesting thing about irregular fasting is that it can start autophagy. During fasting, especially long fasts or fasts with limited calories, cell energy levels drop, which makes cells start autophagy as a way to stay alive. Autophagy helps cells deal with the metabolic stress of fasting by reusing and breaking down parts of cells. This helps cells recover and become stronger. Real-life examples. 1. Healthspan extension. Studies show that intermittent fasting may improve autophagy, which may help people live longer and delay age-related illnesses. For instance, research on animal models has shown that irregular fasting encourages autophagy in many tissues, which leads to better metabolic health and a longer lifespan. 2. Neuroprotection. Increasing autophagy through intermittent fasting may protect neurons, lowering the chance of neurodegenerative diseases like Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. Intermittent fasting has been shown in both human and animal studies to improve the body's ability to get rid of harmful protein aggregates that are linked to these conditions. This protects neuronal function and memory. 3. Cancer prevention and treatment. Autophagy that is triggered by intermittent fasting has also been linked to cancer prevention and treatment. Preclinical studies show that fasting may make cancer cells more sensitive to chemotherapy and stop tumor growth through processes involving autophagy. This suggests that fasting may be a useful addition to other cancer treatments. The interaction between autophagy and intermittent fasting shows a strong way for cells to clean up and regenerate, which has huge effects for health and longevity. People may be able to trigger autophagy and improve cellular health by using the benefits of intermittent fasting. This could lower the risk of age-related diseases and improve overall health. But more research is needed to find out the best ways to fast and how they affect people's health in the long run. As we continue to learn more about autophagy and fasting, one thing is clear: making healthy food choices and fasting every so often are the first steps toward renewing cells. Who can gain from fasting every so often for autophagy? Intermittent fasting can trigger autophagy, which may be good for many people, especially those who want to improve their health and lower their risk of getting age-related illnesses. Autophagy and irregular fasting may work better together for the following groups. Individuals who are healthy. Intermittent fasting can improve metabolic health and cell renewal, even if you don't have any special health problems. By activating autophagy on a regular basis, people may improve their general health and possibly live longer. Aging population. Autophagy works less well as we get older, which can lead to age-related diseases and degenerative processes. Intermittent fasting is a natural way to boost autophagy, which may slow down the aging process and help people age in a healthy way. People who are at risk for neurodegenerative disorders. Problems with autophagy are linked to neurodegenerative diseases like Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. Intermittent fasting may help get rid of harmful protein buildups that are linked to these conditions, protecting neurons and possibly lowering the risk of getting sick. Cancer patients and survivors, autophagy has a complicated role in cancer, affecting both stopping tumor growth and letting tumors live. Autophagy-induced intermittent fasting has been looked at as an extra way to treat cancer that might make cancer cells more sensitive to treatment and improve the results of treatment. Metabolic syndrome and obesity. Intermittent fasting can improve metabolic health by helping you lose weight, making your body more sensitive to insulin, and lowering inflammation. Inducing autophagy may help these metabolic effects by getting rid of broken parts of cells and making cells work better. Athletes and fitness fans. Intermittent fasting is becoming more popular among athletes and fitness fans because it can help them lose weight and improve their performance. Initiating autophagy may help muscles heal and adapt to exercise, which could improve recovery and general athletic performance. People who have risk factors for heart disease. Autophagy protects heart health by getting rid of broken proteins and lipids in cells and lowering oxidative stress. Autophagy may help lower cardiovascular risk factors like high blood pressure, cholesterol, and inflammation when you fast for short periods of time. People with autoimmune conditions. Autophagy controls inflammation and immune responses, and problems with it are linked to autoimmune illnesses. Intermittent fasting may help control how the immune system works and lower inflammation, which could help people with autoimmune diseases feel better. Intermittent fasting-induced autophagy has potential benefits for many groups, but people should be very careful when starting to fast, especially those who already have health problems or special food needs. If you want to make sure that intermittent fasting is safe and will help you reach your health goals, you should talk to a doctor or nurse before starting. What age do you have to be? Intermittent fasting can cause autophagy, which may be good for people of all ages, from teens to older adults. But it's important to think about your own health, food needs, and metabolic factors when starting a fasting plan. 1. Adults. Intermittent fasting-induced autophagy may help many adults, especially those who want to improve their metabolic health, lose weight, or lower their risk of age-related illnesses. According to research, intermittent fasting can help cells renew themselves faster, make the metabolism more flexible, and lower the risk of diseases like obesity, type 2 diabetes, and heart disease. People in their middle years. As people age, cellular repair processes like autophagy may slow down, which can lead to disease and degeneration that come with getting older. Intermittent fasting might be able to stop this decrease by increasing autophagy, which helps cells renew themselves, and increasing health span. 3. Older adults. Intermittent fasting may still be good for older adults, but they need to be very careful when doing it, especially if they already have health problems or don't get enough nutrients. Before starting a fasting plan, it's best to talk to a doctor or nurse to make sure it's safe and right for you. This is especially important for older adults who may have special food needs or medical concerns. Age alone isn't always a barrier to getting the benefits of intermittent fasting-induced autophagy. However, each person's health, nutritional needs, and any underlying medical conditions should be carefully looked at to see if fasting is safe and suitable for people of all ages who needs to stay away. There are possible benefits to intermittent fasting for many people, but there are some groups that should be careful or not do it at all. People with eating disorders. For people with eating disorders like anorexia nervosa, bulimia nervosa, or binge eating disorder, fasting may make their disordered eating worse and cause them to act in dangerous ways. If this sounds like you, fasting might make your relationship with food and body image even worse. It's important to put your healing first and get help from medical professionals who treat eating disorders. Women who are pregnant or breastfeeding. During pregnancy and breastfeeding, the body needs a lot of nutrients. If a mother fasts during these times, she and her growing baby may not get enough of these nutrients. Women who are pregnant or nursing should make sure they get all the nutrients they need and talk to their doctors before starting a fasting plan. Children and adolescents. As they grow, kids and teens need more calories and nutrients to support their health, development, and growth. Intermittent eating might not be right for this group of people, because it can make it hard to get enough nutrients and mess up normal growth patterns. To help them grow and develop, kids and teens should eat well-balanced meals. People with certain medical conditions, people with diabetes, hypoglycemia, or metabolic disorders may need to carefully watch their fuel intake and blood sugar levels throughout the day. Intermittent fasting might make it harder to control blood sugar, so people with these conditions might not be able to do it. People who already have health problems should talk to their doctors before starting any fasting dietary plan. People who are taking certain drugs, some medications may need to be taken with food in order to be absorbed better, or to reduce the risk of side effects. People who take medications should talk to their doctors to find out if intermittent fasting could affect their health or cause problems with their meds. Last but not least, people should listen to their bodies, put their health and well-being first, and talk to a doctor before starting any fasting plan, especially if they are in one of the groups listed above. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. Let's meet again in new videos. Stay healthy.